This is a memorial facility dedicated to Zhang Zhongjing, a famous Chinese pharmacologist and physician of the Eastern Han Dynasty. Chinese President Xi Jinping visited here in May 2021. She said, the Chinese nation relied on traditional Chinese medicine to treat diseases and save lives for thousands of years. Having fought against COVID-19, SARS, and other major infectious diseases, we have a deeper understanding of the role of traditional Chinese medicine. Highlighting the need to promote traditional Chinese medicine development, she said efforts should be made to interpret the mechanism of traditional Chinese medicine and pharmacology with modern science and to incorporate both traditional Chinese medicine and Western medicine into treatment. In the late Eastern Han Dynasty, the wars raged on and many people were afflicted with plagues. In less than 10 years, more than 130 of Zhang's 200-plus family members died of illness. Some 90 of them died of febrile diseases.
Zhang Zhongjing, as a doctor, faced such a social reality, very sad.他就开始勤求古训博采众方，不断去总结前人的医学理论，广泛收集治疗伤寒的药方。
After years of efforts, Zhang collated the treatise on febrile diseases and miscellaneous illnesses, a prescription, lung cleansing and detoxifying decoction, which have been clinically proven effective for COVID-19 treatment, originates from the book.This ceramic acupuncture statue from the Eastern Han Dynasty is one of the earliest meridian models in China.
针灸学是研究如何运用针刺和艾灸等方法防治疾病的一门学科，是中医学的重要组成部分。它的治疗病谱很广，但是呢，工具很简单，一根银针包含着中华文明的智慧，对病人往往可以起到非常好的治疗效果。
Nobel laureate Tu Youyou led the discovery of malaria drug artemisinin, which has saved millions of lives worldwide, according to incomplete statistics from the World Health Organization. She said she drew inspiration from a 4th century Chinese book, Handbook of Prescriptions for Emergencies.
受到我们老祖宗的启发，从青蒿里面找到青蒿素是不太容易。中医药人一定能把中医药这些祖先留给我们的宝贵财富继承好、发展好、利用好。
China had 767,000 traditional Chinese medicine personnel by the end of 2020. Traditional Chinese medicine has also been introduced.196 countries and regions, and 30 traditional Chinese medicine centers have been established overseas. She urged the preservation and development of traditional Chinese medicine and breakthroughs in core technologies in key areas, as well as more protection, care and support for health workers.
我们崇文总书记讲述的中医药的故事，就是要坚持中西医并重，大力发展中医药事业，在建设健康中国、实现中国梦的伟大征程中谱写新的篇章。